नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, स्टैंडर्ड 10th इंग्लिश 1.2 एन एनकाउंटर ऑफ अ स्पेशल काइंड पार्ट 4 पैराफ्रेज। इन पार्ट 3 वी हैव स्टडीड मार्जिन लाइन एक्टिविटीज एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू पैराफ्रेज द कंप्लीट स्टोरी। द टाइटल ऑफ द स्टोरी इज एप्ट और अप्रोप्रिएट। एन एनकाउंटर of a special kind. An encounter. Encounter is a noun. Its meaning is sudden and unexpected meeting. It has another context. The other meaning is battle or confrontation. Here, in this story, the writer narrates a sudden and unexpected incident. During this incident, we come to know there was a deadly attack on a baby langur by a big male langur. The line on page number 9, para number 2. A big male langur, apparently the leader of its group, was holding a baby langur in his hands and mercilessly biting it all over with a definite intent to kill. Para number 1, pleasure of reading the beauty of nature. As a reader, we can imagine the visualization of the beautiful garden with luxurious compound, green grass, colorful flowers, tall and majestic trees, seasonal vegetables, squirrels, many species of birds, a group of langurs, their den in an aswatha tree there. So, this description of the beauty of nature at the place soothes us. So it's a pleasure of reading the beauty of nature. Para number 2. An introduction to the incident and its deep impact on the writer's mind is narrated. Through that incident, the writer realized the wonders of God's creation, the timing, event, and place is described here. Here, in this para, we come to know the writer's passion for reading. Para number 3, the habit of his family members taking naps in the afternoon, as well as some sounds represented through the words snoring, chirping, cawing, shrill call, ticking of a clock. Despite of all these sounds, the narrator or the writer was deeply absorbed, means completely engrossed in reading the book. So his concentration is highlighted in adverse condition. Para number 4, furious barking of street dogs. The writer's prediction: an unfortunate pig being attacked, cawing of a flock of crows, that is cacophony. Finally, he lost his concentration in reading. An adventure story, and was curious what exactly was happening. So, though he was engrossed in reading the storybook, due to the cacophony of the crows and the furious barking of the street dogs, he was disturbed and he wanted to know what exactly had happened. Para number 5, the actual encounter is described here in this para. Recalling of the terrible custom in the animal clan is also described here. And in para number 6, the writer came in an action mode. I gathered a stout stick in one hand and hurled a piece of stone at the marauding langur. The langur was so infuriated that it hardly took any notice of my assault. But then I started throwing more stones. So These lines show us the writer came in an action mode, or the narrator came in an action mode. Para number 7. The meaning of the word encounter is revealed here with both contexts. The climax of the incident is shown here. The baby was listless and appeared to be dead. The prospect of a good kill and meal. The writer's confrontation with the pack of dogs. His attempts to save the baby langur have been described. Para number 8 tells us about a rescue operation. Para number 9, the injured baby langur, writer's sincere attempts to let it survive, his family members' support in rescue operation. Para number 10, continuous efforts of the writer or the narrator to save the baby langur. Para number 11, revival of the baby langur. Here, human-animal relationship, trust and mutual understanding is revealed. The line in this para is the sound proof of human-animal relationship. There sat the mother langur on our kitchen roof, watching every move I made. She simply sat there quietly, as if convinced that no harm was being done to her child. Para number 12, writer's presence of mind is revealed here. When the mother langur wanted to go closer to her baby, the writer came to know and he gave access to mother langur. The line, soundproof of the line, or the witness of this, the line is, I retreated from the door of the coop to allow the mother access to her baby. So this line shows it very clearly. The narrator or the writer kept his presence of mind. Para number 13. The meeting of mother langur and baby langur is described here. The feeling of joy and safety is revealed. The proof of this is, the baby found great solace in her caring arms. Para number 14, human-animal relationship again is revealed. For the second time, the line giving the witness of this, the mother langur looked straight into my eyes. Even today, I cannot forget that look in her eyes, showering silent gratitude on me for saving her child. The writer or the narrator in the story was overwhelmed by the emotions and sentiments of the mother langur. Para number 15, safety measures implemented by mother langur are described here in this para. Para number 16, important message through this story is given in this paragraph. Interspecies communication and mutual trust is indeed a reality. Anyone can realize these emotions and sentiments directly. We should maintain sound and trustworthy relationship between man and animal. Means of establishing a bond between man and animal. Number 1, trust. Number 2, compassion. Number 3, mutual understanding. And number 4, love. So friends, this story is different one, unique one, because nowadays everywhere in the world we see man versus wild conflict, confrontation, But here, an encounter described in the story is different one. This encounter was the sudden meeting and an attack by a male langur, and after that, the narrator or the writer's intervention and sincere attempts to save the baby langur, and later on, mother langur's feeling of gratitude through her eyes and the sentiments described by the narrator or the writer tells us that the compassion, आपण ज्याला आपल्या मातृभाषेमध्ये म्हणतो भूत दया, मुक्या प्राण्यांवर दया करा, दिस इज अ टीचिंग थ्रू अवर ट्रॅडिशन. कम्पॅशन इज अ व्हॅल्यू, ह्युमन व्हॅल्यू, अँड वी मस्ट प्रिझर्व इट थ्रू अवर ॲक्ट, व्हॉट द नरेटर इन द स्टोरी हॅज शोन अस. सो दिस इज अन आयडियल कंडक्ट ऑर बिहेवियर ऑफ द नरेटर that should be followed by every reader. We should have the compassion towards all kinds of animals, domestic animals as well as wildlife, because they are also equally important part of the nature cycle. So the message at the end of the story is very important. We should have trust, compassion, mutual understanding and love for all kinds of animals. So the story is really very interesting. It is written by Tapan Mukherjee. So in this part 4, we have learnt the paraphrasing of the entire story. This will definitely helpful to you. This will be definitely helpful to you to understand the story and for doing the evaluation activities. Now friends, homework. My English course book 10, page number 12, English workshop, activity number 1, 3, 4 and 5 is for homework. We have studied the story. You have listened and read the story, you have studied the vocabulary, and you have now learnt the complete paraphrasing of the story. So activity number 1, this is factual, simple factual kind of activity. Reading the statements and telling whether you agree or disagree. Then activity number 3, you have to write your answers to the given questions, as well as activity number 4, you have to rearrange the occurrence of happening in the text in a sequential order of the textbook, the text or the story. And then activity number 5, open-ended questions have been given. So I again repeat, on page number 12 and 13, English workshop of this story 1.2, an encounter of a special kind, English workshop activity number 1, 3, 4 and 5 for homework. Thank you.